did. The floor is yours. Molecular diagnostics in the treating of operable forms of lung cancer. There's a topic, there's no such role as of today, but I had to occupy my time. So I will torture you now. If we speak about the role, if we speak about perspectives, we may divide this into different stages. Neoadjuvant, adjuvant therapies, assessment of the results of this of surgery, whether it is needed or not, post-op monitoring of the disease recurrence, and early diagnostics of the lung cancer. As of today, the lion's share of the tests we have is one way or other connected with the drugs, but these drugs are registered to treat metastatic lung cancers. And when the same mutation tests are transferred onto the operable lung cancer, I agree. If we speak about adjuvant therapy, I agree with Daniil. This is the previous speaker. This is very important and this should be done. But as of today, these are two different pairs of shoes. Molecular diagnostics of lung cancer per se and molecular diagnostics to prescribe drugs for metastatic non-operable lung cancer. Here we have the range of mutations that have to be selected in order to select the drugs, different population of patients. In other cases, it is the diagnostics of the tumor of as the prevalence of the process. This is probably not a very honest example when we speak about neoadjuvant therapy, operable lung cancer. We assume that this is more or less operable cancer at the moment of diagnostics, and therapy is prescribed for specific reasons. There is a position that this allows to decrease the volume of the resection. There is another position that though the tumor decreases, we have to resect in the same volume. But this is these are conditionally operable forms. Slightly different situation. These are Yevgeny Levchenko's patients. Initially, it was non-operable cancer, but look, these publications date back to 2009, and they demonstrate that if the patient has a mutation, tyrosine kinase inhibitor is prescribed properly, we can have surgery afterwards. In oncology, it may happen that the conversion of non-operable forms happens into operable ones. I like the ideology in itself. If we speak about the peculiarities of this metastatic process, it is absolutely unreasonable to carry on systemic therapy if the patient has several foci remaining. You know that the foci diminish in size, and then a few of them remain, and they remain intact on the background of therapy. There is no reason to carry on with systemic therapy if the foci do not diminish further. This is systemic therapy, and the interaction of various specialties, traditional surgery, radiosurgery, and we still have to work a lot here. At least for thoracic surgeons, it's the field of work. From time to time, such things are performed in hospital number 62 in our center. The so-called residual metastatic focus. I think this is the right approach, but clinical trials are needed to confirm this. Another point. Thanks to such works, we can learn something new. This is not a work of practical nature. There's a patient who first was prescribed tyrosine kinase inhibitors, but then on the background of a very good result, she asked to be operated upon. When it is, appeared, it was said that it was a laser effect because apnea, pains, and the symptoms of the disease took just several hours. If you look at x-rays, there's no such a dynamic on CT. for the tumor to diminish so quickly. That was our work when we suspected that the symptoms are caused not by the size of the tumor per se, but the discharge of inflammatory factors or cytokines. You see, the initial tumor and the 3 weeks after a prescription, cytokines were discharged, which led to pain and inflammation. Another example, the patient received ROS inhibitor, and she has only one focus, which Evgeny reserves. The most important question here, so we've resected the focus, what next? If we look at the rules developed to treat other tumors, they are very clear. If we see in the biopsy single tumor cells, it means that tumor cells remain in the body and this systemic therapy has to be continued. If we do not see this residual tumor cells, we may do without the adjuvant, and no adjuvant to rizatinib is given anywhere. The pathologist, the morphologist, looks at the tumor preparation or tumor cells, translocation may happen, and molecular diagnostics methods are much more sensitive compared to morphology. The morphologist doesn't see anything. He says no tumor cells, and then we carry out molecular analysis, very routine one. But alas, we have translocation signs. There's other nuance. Another morphologist may check this preparation, and he laughed at the first morphologist. How come not seen? Quite clear tumor cells are present. We can't train all the morphologists. If there is a semi-automatic method that works independently of morphologists, that's great, because it may resolve the problem of reproducibility. And in this case, it was quite evident to me that the future is in this method. These methods are better in terms of sensitivity, specificity, and they are more objective. Lots of hopes are connected with liquid biopsy. What is liquid biopsy? If we have tumor, some of the tumor cells degrade. Most probably when these cells degrade, the mutated DNA may be detected in the cellular fraction of the blood. Look, we have the mutation range for metastatic lung cancer. If we speak about liquid biopsy, the situation is different here. A good mutation that allows us to treat happen in case of adenocarcinoma, but in adenocarcinoma we don't have such a degradation of tumor cells. Liquid biopsy in adenocarcinoma is low informative because the tumor is intact. Squamous cell lungs are more interesting from this point of view. But they have mutations also that are the markers of the tumor. Anyway, liquid biopsy is a workable method as of today. What it allows us to do? You have operated upon the patient. You have to know the mutations in the initial tumor, and then you perform blood test. You know whether the tumor was resected radically or not. But this is important because, in perspective, such patients most probably will we have to decide whether to prescribe the adjuvant therapy or not. If you follow up such patients, this test 2 months earlier allows to predict a recurrence, dissemination of the process, not a local recurrence. Is it important? To be honest, I do not think so. If you detect the signs of systemic disease 70 days earlier, And even if you started systemic therapy 2 months earlier, you most probably won't change the fate of the patient. In parallel with breast cancer, yes, when the patients were followed up, chemotherapy was prescribed earlier. They lived though the same as the other patients, but they lived worse because the period of chemotherapy was longer for them. And the control of efficacy of the adjuvant therapy, look what was shown in clinical trials. Operated patients receive adjuvant therapy. If in the process of adjuvant therapy, the titer of the tumor DNA goes down, it means that adjuvant therapy really works. They have better prognosis than other patients. Are we going to change adjuvant therapy based on these tests? Difficult to say because the choice is not that broad for adjuvant therapy, but some possibilities and some hopes exist. What is the problem here? Liquid biopsy works very badly when the limit of detection of CT exists. If the tumor is 1 cubic centimeter, 1 gram, that's the limit of detection. And most probably you won't see anything in liquid biopsy here. This test works when the overall volume of tumor mass is from 10 to 100 grams. And there are works going on in this direction. I'm not going to speak about adjuvant therapy. Daniel already said everything, but I just joined him. No doubt, we have no standards. But I'm not afraid to say to the patient, if your tumor, operated tumor is higher than first stage, the majority of patients, if you have EGFR, ALK mutations, and if you have a possibility to stick to adjuvant therapy, tyrosine kinase inhibitors, it may be very good. It's very difficult. We do not know how to treat these patients when they have relapses, they may have resistant forms. If we take real clinical trials, it is not the situation, it's not as bad. Because the intake of the drug was limited, and when the relapses took place, when they stopped the drug intake, and what are the adequate dosages? Do we have to use the same strength of the drug for the metastasis as for the adjuvant? Aromatase inhibitors is given for 10 years in case of breast cancer, and here only 2 years. Why so? No rational explanation. Actually, the cost of the therapy. The optimists think that earlier or later, all the types of cancer will be detected based on liquid biopsy. RNA and DNA markers give us better characteristics compared to ordinary markers. The logic is as follows. We take the most frequent mutations, perform the test based on molecular markers, and one way or other, what does this study show us? At least if we look at lung cancer, approximately 50% of tumors at the level of operable stages 1, 2, 3 already have in blood flow the signs of tumor DNA. In theory, these patients might have been detected based on DNA test in screening. But detection is one pair of shoes, and whether this test will allow us to cure these patients is a totally different level of complication and pair of shoes. But this is a very interesting area of work. Thank you. Evgeny, what about the threshold of detection? 1 centimeter. Right? Which size will allow us to minimally but sufficiently, with great level of probability, detect tumor DNA? 1 centimeter is the threshold of detection as of today for an ideal situation with tomography. If we take liquid biopsy, its parameters are worse. The overall size of focus have to be 10 grams, and this is 3 centimeters. But there are many developments in terms of how to improve these parameters. How successful they will turn out, it's very difficult to predict, but what is being thought and what is being done. But it's a fact that we are now much better compared to 3 years ago. Is this method in demand? Certainly. From the very beginning, I told you nothing for me to talk about.